starts the next week and a half? Not even to determine the starter, but what do you need to see out of them?
You know, we always say it, but consistency. Consistency every single day. The ability to make the routine play, the routine call, calls, a command presence about themselves, so the way they lead their football team, the command presence at the line of scrimmage, getting us in the right plays, a poise and a calmness, and then accuracy, putting the ball where we can make some plays. There's a lot that goes into it. And, you know, I thought they came out today just like everyone. I liked their approach to practice today. Sometimes with the football team, you know, a bye week, you can take a different approach mentally, and our players came out that it was a work week, and there was a workmanlike approach, and I thought we got a lot accomplished today.
Coach, with Quinton's ball security issues, when you look on tape, is it decision making or is it just simply accuracy?
I think it's a combination. I think every you know, ball security issue that's occurred, it's been a nuance in and of itself. You know, whether it's late on a rhythm and timing of a pass game or not chinning the ball with running the football, sometimes it's the snap. So I think it's been a combination of a lot of things, and we worked extremely hard. You know, when you look at the number one statistic for winning, it's turnover margin. And right now, you know, we've always prided ourselves in turnover margin, and we're minus four, and that's an area where this football team needs to step up. We need to get better. We've really demanded it. There's 11 teams in the country that have a minus four turnover margin, and only three of them have winning records, and we're one of them. So that, I think that shows you the value of turnover margin.
Coach, obviously there's some outside noise right now. How do you, when it comes to recruiting, how do you tell recruits, you know, you need to block that out, everything's good over here?
I think it stems from relationships. You know, that's all part of it. We live in a week-to-week society, and, you know, you build relationships with these young men and their families. They've been here a lot on campus. They know what we're about as players, as coaches. They know what we're about as people. They know our players exceptionally well, and they know the program, and they know where we're headed, and they know what we've been able to do. So, you know, again, that's all part of it, but it really comes down to relationships.
On a personal level for you, how difficult is it to kind of just stay focused through all this with all the stuff that's said?
It's all part of the territory. It's pretty easy on me. I get up, I come to work, I don't listen to anything. And again, all our focus is on South Carolina. All of our focus is on this work week, but it does not affect me or the staff at all.
Have you had to remind that to your players as well in terms of just make sure? Have you had to say that sure. Anything different this week than you had in the past? Regardless?
Well, I think each week is different because of the circumstances, so your message is tailored for that particular week, whether it's your opponent or whether it's a bye week or the circumstances around them. So again, you know, all we have is each other. We got to work every single day, and we're responsible for what we create. And again, the only way you have to do is you have to go about work every single day, and you have to work to win, and you have to deserve victory in everything that you do. And they understand, you know, the things that we have to, you know, get much better on with the turnover margin, the physicality, the tackling, all those things that go into playing winning football.
Coach, when you watch the tape, what did you see in the line of scrimmage for your football team Saturday?
Yeah, you know, that's why you watch the tape over and over and over again. And I think the thing, you know, we've talked to our football team is about synergy. Is everybody working together, and that's why it's a great team sport. Nine individuals would do the right thing, play with the right technique, the right pad level, and there'd be two individuals on one play, three individuals on another, one individual on another play. And if 11 individuals aren't working collectively as one, you're not going to have success. And that was really what I saw. I saw, you know, a lot of individual breakdowns and not just one particular person. And that's where the synergy working together comes. And it's the same thing defensively. In the first half, you know, they have eight possessions, and five of them we generate five three and outs, but then we give up three scores. And then if you look at it, we gave up five runs over 100 plus yards, and then the rest of the runs, and again, it was an eight-man spacing and gapped out defense. So again, it's going back and defining why did they happen, what could we have done better, define the techniques, and come out here and work. And our players understand that, and that's why I like their approach today.
Coach, when you watch game tape, how do you critique yourself, or how can a head coach critique himself? Obviously, you're not a play caller, but right. Are there moments where you're saying, I should have done this, or
you always, I mean, that's all part of it. You know, when you watch the game, you always look at it as your worst critic. You know, what could you have done better in this situation? Sometimes I'll refer back to practice. You know, how many times did we rep that particular defense or that particular play? did we put our players in positions to succeed, game management type things, style of play, demands, sideline etiquette, all that. You know, I always approach it as I'm my own worst critic, and we take great pride in that, and that's another whole entire area with our style of play that we've done such a good job in the past, and we need to get back to our style of play and our expectations of Tennessee football.
But which is a coaching staff. How much do you guys have to, you know, and you the leader, kind of sit down and go, you know, we're good coaches, let's just kind of figure out how to get this thing going?
Well, we spent a lot of time together. And again, we spent a lot of time the last couple days of really going through the entire season, you know, going through obviously the last game and then looking forward to the next game. But again, we're adults, we're professionals, but we are human. But again, all our focus is not on our feelings or how we feel. All our focus is on our football team, our football program, and our players and our recruiting. And that's the most important thing. And, you know, all you do is you continue to work every single day, and we'll be fine.
All right, thank you.
Thanks, Coach.